What's up, guys? Welcome back to my Borderlands 2 final LP, episode 74. And we gotta get this LP moving! Moving! Gotta get to OP8. Gotta get to OP8 before Borderlands pre-sequel comes out 14th of next month. We don't got much time. I think we got like 30 days or less. Something like that. I think it's almost, a little bit under a month. Just a tiny bit under a month. But anyway, we're gonna go ahead and, we don't need to do Crown Rax's DLC, do we? Nah, we don't need to do that. Why would we need to do that? Let's focus on the ones that are actually important. Like, I would like a Pimpernel going into, Ultimate Vault Hunter mode. So, where is Pirate's Booty? Pirate Booty. There it is. Oasis! We're gonna start off with Oasis. I've thought about, like, the gear and stuff that I kinda wanna go ahead and get. Also, hold on. There's gonna be a cutscene, and you guys get to hear it. I can't remember if it was sound effects or dialogue volume. But let's see. There we go. Listen away.
A long time ago, there was a big pile of treasure in the desert. And the Vault Hunters found it and killed all the bad guys. The end.
No, that's not how you start a story.
I thought it was pretty good.
And I think you're not getting fed this week. Now, this is how you start a story. Legends speak of Captain Blades, lost treasure of the sands. Of a prize so great that men would turn their sands red in pursuit of it. Of a pirate queen, courageous and deadly, who would stop at nothing to find it. Of a monstrous leviathan, of the Vault Hunters who journeyed to the desert town of Oasis, not knowing the horrors that would befall them. See, that's how you do it.
Mine was more succinct.
Your life's gonna be succinct, you dirty little orphan.
Damn, Marcus, that's mean. This LP needs to be succinct. I don't know if I said that word right. Succinct. Something like that. That's what he said, right? No, not video. We don't need to go into video. Let's pop this back down to one. Go. Anyway. Yeah, we don't have much time for this LP. If I want to get to OP8 by the end of it, I gotta get moving. I gotta get moving because once the 14th comes around, if the LP is not done by the time the 14th comes around, the LP will end. It will end because once the pre-sequel comes out, this LP is done. It's done. Whether I'm at OP8 or not, so I gotta get moving, guys. I gotta get moving. I got a month to do this. I got a month. I have to think about exactly what is worth like recording and what's not. I'm obviously not gonna record any of the farming because there are a few things that I want to farm good versions of, and that would be the Pimpernel, the Kitten, the Hail. Probably Herald because the Herald is just good to have. Getting a grog nozzle is simple, so I don't need to worry about that one. Those are like the only guns that come to mind that I really see myself needing. I just, with all, like, I'm sure whatever I find along the way could help me out too. What am I doing here? We don't need to go here. We don't need to go there. Just for, you know, starting out of UVHM, I need somewhat good gear. I also may go onto one of my, like, higher level characters and use their Seraph Crystals to buy me, like, an antagonist or something like that. Maybe even, or I could just kill the dragons for a blockade. That wouldn't be too bad. We'll see what I go with, but, I'm trying to keep the amount of gear that I'm going to farm for, pretty limited, mainly because I don't have a lot of time. And the most I could force out a day is, like, maybe one LP episode a day, but even then, I don't think I'm gonna do, like, one LP episode a day, because, I don't know, I've never done that. I haven't done that in a long time. Did I ever put, like, LP episodes up, like, one every day? I don't know. I don't think I ever did that. You're gonna give me a, what's it called? You're gonna give me a stink pot, because I need a stink pot. Not really. But, whoever needs a stink pot? Yo, back up. I forgot I have this thing. Go, dev, go! But, yeah, so what DLCs would I really need to get done? Honestly, Hammerlocks, I would get done if I could get a Twister. Here's the thing, though. Farming for a Twister is stupid, and I don't want to do it. I could, like, make the game think it's 4-player, but even then, I don't know. I think I'll just leave the Twister out of here, even though the Twister's so good. I could take a Twister from one of my other level 50 characters, but nah, let's not do that. We don't need it. I got a conference call. I'll be fine. Also, I gotta go back over to this guy. But yeah, so I don't think I need anything in Hammerlocks. So we could basically skip Hammerlocks. There's nothing that comes to mind that I would really need. I mean, a yellow jacket, not really. That kitty's smacking its mama's titties. And Tiny Tina's DLC, of course, and this DLC, of course, it's the other one. And Torg, of course, yes, I'll need it. So I could skip Hammerlocks. That DLC could be done in one episode, if I really wanted to. Just 1-hour-long episode, I could get that done. But, if I don't need to, might as well not do it. Might as well not do it. Might as well not. Might as well. Just to save time, you know, just to save time. Gotta get to OP8. I gotta go, like, super, super fast. Super fast. Super Sonic speed. Sonic speed. Also gotta get, Nate in here. For an episode. Forgot about that. Gotta figure out what episode. Gotta figure out when he's available. Available. For some reason, something's, like, yelling at me that his name isn't Nate. But it is Nate. Because I wouldn't forget. I wouldn't forget that easily. Watch, I somehow forgot. And I think his name is Nate, but it's really not. No, his name's Nate. I know it for a fact. Know it for a fact. But yeah, gotta get him on for an episode, this final LP, before I finish it off. Boy, yeah. Also gotta go... Leveling this character, I'll probably just... I may do leveling for this character, on stream or something, to be honest. Like, from... Let's say, you know, okay, I have to run through the story mode rather quickly, I might add. I have to run through the UVHM story mode. And then I have to run through the DLCs of UVHM. And by that time, there's no way I'll be level 72 by that time. I'll be, like, around level 60-something at that time, I believe. Oh, God. Something like that. Oh, there's a thing up. It's up there, right? Yeah. Yeah. Can I get up there again? I think it's like this. Yeah, like that. There was lag within that. But yeah. I don't know exactly how I'm going to go at it, but... I don't know. I got to move quickly, guys. I gotta do this. I got to do this super fast, super sonic speed. Everything. Pre-sequel's coming, guys, and my hype is hitting. My hype is hitting. I may have mentioned this last episode or something, but, wait, no, I don't think I've talked about this. Like, dividing time between Destiny, whenever I do get it, and Borderlands, the pre-sequel. How could I do that? How could I possibly do that? And then I do Pokemon stuff on the side, too, so how would I divide all that? I don't know if these, like, bigger YouTubers do this kind of stuff. I don't know. They probably have faster internet speed, that's probably it. But even then, recording and stuff, and editing it, it takes the same amount of time. I don't know how they do it. They're like pros and still have time to do other stuff. I don't know. How did they do this? What powers do they possess that I do not possess yet? I've ascended to like Super Saiyan 4 or 5 in this LP, so I should have these powers, but I don't. Yeah, but still. Also, I don't want to just like pump out like videos like a machine gun, like 5 videos a day, like coming your way. That doesn't what I say. Wait, I'm doing a Shady Penguin thing, but I failed at it completely. Shady Penguin's a Pokemon YouTuber. In case you guys didn't know. Give him my thing. But yeah. The most videos I'd probably ever put out in a day is 3. Unless, like, there's, like, a minute or 2 minute, like, side video or something that I could put out. You know, then I'd do that. But I don't know. I never want to find myself spamming your guys' inbox. I know some of you might like that, but some of you may not. And I don't really have the time for that, to be completely honest. Stop that. Especially when I have, like, a writing hobby that can take up easily 2 or 3 hours out of the day. Because when I write, and I write for a while, and I get a lot. Normally when I write, I'll sit down, I'll write 15, 16 pages in, like, 3-4 hours before I stop. Normally, unless I get distracted, which can happen a lot, but still. I don't know. So if I do get Destiny, which I really want to, honestly, it's something different, and I want it. I want. It's gonna be grindy, it's gonna take up time, but I want it. I want the time vampires. Give me the time vampires that I call video games. That we call video games. Because pre-sequel and Destiny, those are easily time vampires. They aren't like MMO time vampires, but still. Actually, you know what? To me, those games would sap more time away from me than an MMO would. Because I've played MMOs. They don't sap my time away. They don't. Because I don't sit there and just, like, blaze through the MMO or whatever. I don't know. Me and MMOs, I don't know. Don't mix too well. But I know Destiny and the pre-sequel I can mix with very well, and they would sap my time away forever. I don't know. I need more time in the day, guys. Double the amount of time in the day. Give us 48-hour day cycles. Come on. Alter the universe for me, guys. It'll work out for us all. And if they try to, like, double school hours along with that, no. We kidnap Obama. We kidnap Obama. That's what we do. Can I get in trouble for saying that? I'm going to kidnap Obama. I don't think so. I don't think I can. If I can, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Secret Service. Man, I love Obama. Obama's cool. I'm not going to get into politics or anything, though. I just think he's cool. His name is cool. That's what I like about Obama. His name. Barack Obama. That name, though. Barack. Barack Obama. I like that name. That's the main reason why I like him. That's pretty much it. But anyway, I'm going to move away from that before, like, the Secret Service come bursting to my door and murder me. But whatever. Yeah. Anyway, I'm just, like, rambling on again. I think I was talking about, like, somewhat important stuff. Shade, you're wasting my time. I don't have time to waste, man. I don't have time to waste. I don't have time to lollygag with you. Gotta move. Pre-sequel's on its way. Guys, the pre-sequel, though. I cannot tell you how excited I am. Because a lot of you already know, I came into the Borderlands 2 YouTube scene rather late. I came in after Hammerlock's. Yeah, something like that. After Hammerlock's DLC came out, I came in to the YouTube scene. Oh, no. Right before Hammerlock's came out, actually. I came into the YouTube scene. It just sounds exciting to be with a Borderlands game from the start as a YouTuber. It really does. It's a nice opportunity, too. It's a nice opportunity. Fishy. I'm ready to go ham, guys. I'm ready for the ham. Bring me the ham. Damn. I wish you could smell what I'm smelling. Ooh, you bite the fry bites back, my man. Damn. If you haven't heard that song, I recommend it. Search up Damn, like D-A-Y-U-M. Damn. You'll find one of the funniest videos you'll ever see in your life. For real. Almost as funny as the Asian dad with the B+. B plus again. Some of you may know the videos I'm talking about. If you do, high five, Kokomo, high five to you. If you don't, you need to go see them. Oh boy, see, in this playthrough I could run over these guys without, like, my boat just dying. Because if you run over these guys in UVHM, let me run over like two of them and your boat's just dead, which isn't cool at all. Yeah, the pre-sequel hype though, guys. The pre-sequel hype. Also, guys, there's a Gage reference in the pre-sequel. I'm so happy. She's not in the pre-sequel, at least I don't think she is, but she's... There's a reference. Claptrap can turn into a Mechro Magician, and, like, when he does it, the text says, so awesome, but so inaccurate. No, like, sometimes Gage will yell, so inaccurate, but so awesome! In the only way she can. Claptrap, like, his text says the opposite of that. Like, swapped, like, vice versa, sort of, technically, I don't know, just reworded, that's the word, reworded, that's it, I love this conference call, it's so awesome. Mystic Slayers, you the man, even though all he did was say, go for practicable one, I was ready to settle for that crap one I got, I was like, no, go for practicable, I was like, oh, okay, for you, Mystic Slayers, the motivation, guys, motivation come in the smallest of forms. Yeah, I thought that was cool, having, it kind of messes up the continuity of the series, but whatever. Because, like, how would, Claptrap know about that if it doesn't exist quite yet? So what's Gage? How old is Gage in the pre-sequel? Like, 13, 14? It's not too young. I'd be okay with that. I'm gonna stop. Hi, Captain Scarlet. How are you doing? Well, absolutely stab me in the back. That's okay. That's okie dokie Loki. That greed, though. Greed used to be one of my favorite weapons. It really did. I loved the greed. I don't know. Something happened. I just didn't like it anymore. Oh, God, guys. I was choking. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. What was I saying? Nothing about UVHM. But still. God. One of my greatest fears is that UVHM comes back in the pre-sequel. I would die. Like, I'd die right there. I'd move fully to Destiny, guys. If UVHM comes to the pre-sequel, I'm moving fully to Destiny. There is no doubt about that. How long have we been recording? Probably not too long. No, not too long at all. So we could go kill Sandman and end the episode off after that. I could make these episodes bigger, but then they become, you know, that takes longer to run there and takes longer to upload, and it's not cool. But I gotta get to a point where I could, I have to record enough so I could get to a point where I could, like, farm multiple things I'm after on stream. That requires, completing these DLCs. Completing these DLCs. For sure. I can't farm, like, a Pimpernel or anything. Also, a Sandhawk and Bee would be nice, but I never use that on a macro, so I don't really think there's a point. It would help to just speed through everything, but nobody wants to see me run around with a Bee and a Sandhawk killing stuff, right? No! That is not how you macro. I've never once seen a Macromancer actually do that. Ever. I've seen a Macromancer use a Bee. Never seen them use a Beehawk. Ever. Unless that was, like, their only choice. But no. Macromancers, there's more to a Macromancer. There's more to the glorious Mahercomancer than a Bee and a Sandhawk. Same with a Gunzerker. There's more to him. There's Money Shot. And some of you may be like, well, you know, there's more to Gage too. There's Anarchy. No. You can't throw that joke back at me. You can't throw that Gunzerker insult at my Gage. No. Nah. He has close enough too. And blood-soaked shields. Anyway. Let's just, like, murder all these guys. This conference call makes, like, everything too easy, but this is how a legendary gun should feel. You should be able to just mow through enemies like a badass. That's how a legendary gun is supposed to be. Now, in UVHM, of course, there are some characters, you know, that can make legendary guns sort of feel like legendary guns. Like, using a bitch on Maya is overkill. You hit, like two bullets in the critical spot while they're, like, slagged. They will die. You phase lock them up. Two bullets, that's all it takes. They're dead from a bitch. They're dead. As long as you know the element is proper, is like being used properly against the enemy, like, you know, fire on flesh and stuff. I remember when I used the, I made like my siren build, used the Bidl and Maya together. It was amazing. I loved it. And then people are like, this build sucks. I just mowed through an entire area, killing every enemy with less than 2 SMG bullets. What are you talking about? This build sucks. I'll never get the YouTube community. You didn't put this skill there. Yeah, I still mowed through the entire area. 2 SMG bullets. What do? You run around with freaking Beehawk, and I still kill him faster. Oh well. I'm ready for that in the pre-sequel. I'm ready for that. You don't know how to play, retard. Yeah, I'm ready. Borderlands 2 has prepared me. I'm ready. I'm ready for the hate. It's funny, though. Most of the time, like... What, like, oh god, like 90% of the time it's funny. 10% of the time it hurts, but 90% of the time it's funny, because they just have no idea what they're talking about. It's so good. They brighten up my day, and sometimes completely destroy it. But that's less frequently, at least. Anyway. See, this is good. I'm not talking about Destiny, I'm talking about the pre-sequel more. Right? Right, guys? Right. That's good. But yeah. Look at this. This is the conference call was the unrivaled shotgun in the Borderlands universe, even after the Bee was nerfed. Because it wasn't because the conference call didn't really rely on the Bee at all. It was still good without the Bee, of course. You could go fight Terra with the conference call Bee combo and still murder him pretty quickly. Even without the Bee, you could, like, mess him up. Axton can solo Terra at level 50. Axton can solo raid bosses at level 50 without requiring something like crappy, what's it called? Like some, well, not necessarily crappy, but all these like strategies and stuff, or these like, these exploits or whatever you want to call them, like the whole like TDR reload thing. Yeah, that's, you shouldn't have to be able to kill a raid boss like that. I really want to see how they handle raids in the pre-sequel. I know there won't be any raids from the start, but they have, like, said that they don't... that they haven't, like, shut down the idea of adding some in, like, DLC. I would love to see what the raid bosses turn into. Like, Son of Vora. Oh, God, don't bring Vora back, no. No. Vora's my little kitty cat, and I love it, but it's just... it murders me a lot. A lot at OP8. A lot. A lot. Vora is a punk! Vora is like one of the... OP8 Vora is one of the hardest bosses you'll probably ever fight. It's mainly because it just spam attacks you and you can't dodge it. It's a poorly designed boss, but that's what makes it so hard. Like, I've even seen Dark Souls 2 bosses. They're hard, but there are strategies to beat them. Vora, there's like point and loot with a herald and a grog nozzle. Get away, Rabbit Skag. Rabbit Spags. Rabbit Skags give a good amount of XP, which is nice. I know I like to kill everything, but I can't really afford to. We gotta move. As I say when I'm turning back to kill everything again. Let's go. Oh, wait. Do I run through there to get the chests? Or do I run around the other side? I think it's the other side. Yeah, pretty sure. Deadeye Gunner. No! Deadeye! I'm out of ammo. Don't think it really mattered. Let's buy more ammo. Guys, this is a better flare delay. This is a more focused flare delay. This flare delay isn't dying every 5 seconds. This flare delay has direction. Direction. My skill level hasn't went down by 50%, at least yet. Or maybe it's the conference call, isn't it? It's the conference call. No, not really, because I could probably kill just as easily with this stuff. But let's see. How fast do I murder these guys? Yeah, it doesn't really matter. The conference call isn't necessarily making me good. Yay. I don't know. Did he hit back my E-Tech bullet? What? He could do that? Guys. Almost had a 2-year lifespan in this game. I'm still learning things. Isn't that great? That's when you know a game has a lot of content to it. This game has a lot of content to it. It really does. It really, really does. I saw somebody in the comment section of some Rooster Teeth video, because they came out with like some pre-sequel video today on the No, on their No channel, which is awesome, an awesome news channel. I always recommend it. The No. I was like, why is this game? Why? I'll never get why people play this game. It's one of the best looters ever created. It basically defines the genre, honestly. Honestly. And I kind of want to say, from what I've seen, I never thought I would believe this, but from what I've seen, the Borderlands franchise is better than Destiny. For the simple reason that it has more content to it. Destiny is just, you know, all endgame. Borderlands 2 and Borderlands is not exactly like all endgame. It's not. Again, it's all up to opinion, but I'm looking at it from like an unbiased thing, because I expected Destiny to be like way better than Borderlands. I really did. I was like, look at all this hype! Look at all this hype! This is Bungie! Look at how much money they spend in this game! Look at it! Look how much they're pushing this game! This is gonna be like the best game ever! It's not really the best game ever. I have no doubt in my mind that Destiny's a good game. And I think, from what I've seen, that Borderlands, like, as a whole, is better than Destiny. Just because it has more to it. Even though this game right now is way more broken than Destiny. But still. Ow, I went down. You know what? Let's not even risk it. Let's pop out my handy-dandy conference call and murder all the faces. Or I could die. No! Guys, notice how I die when I'm talking about how I'm not dying. Guys, I've lost the direction. I've lost the focus. It's because I started talking about Destiny. I understand now. I understand. Wait, my anarchy. How much anarchy do I have? My anarchy! No! I can't even tell. I should probably summon this guy. He's cool. Tef Trap, you're cool. Go do your thing. Tef Trap didn't exist during the pre-sequel. It's okay. I don't care. The only reason I use this character is for Gage. That's the only reason. Not for Death Trap. I care less about Death Trap. Ow! Stupid cursed pirate. I'm glad that he doesn't take health from Death Trap, because that would suck. These guys, they hit you and then they siphon health. And they just, I don't know, they have weird curses on them. They're freaky looking dudes, too. They're freaky looking dudes. They run like the Titans from Attack on Titan. Some of those Titans run ridiculously weird and funny. I remember seeing one run, I was like, I couldn't help but laugh. And the fact that the characters are scared that that the Titan was, like, running at them when they, like, looked that retarded. I was like, no, life or death, I'd still crack a smile at that. Oh, God. Anyway. Or maybe not. I'm just talking, but still. You've seen Attack on Titan, you know what I'm talking about. Like, these fat Titans just run like a complete retard. A retard! I don't know. Hey there, Big Sleep. What's up, buddy? I want to go up on that ship. Sandman, you're not even relevant. Big Sleep's more relevant than you. Because he drops the unique. Where's your unique, Sandman? He should have dropped the Chiquito Amigo from Borderlands 1. That would have been cool. Chiquito Amigo. Come here, you midlet. Here. Dev, you deal with him. Deal with my light work. I don't even need to attack him. Wait, did Sandman already die? My Teslas killed Sandman. Teslas are so good, guys. Teslas are in the pre-sequel, right? They better be. They are the best kind of grenade. Easily. Next to the chain lightning. No, they're better than the chain lightning. I just, you know, like the chain lightning better. But I have to say, Teslas are the best kind of grenades in this game. Come on, Scarlet. Come on. Yeah, like that. There we go, perfect. Let's go ahead and look in here, and then we'll head back to our ship and end the episode off there after we drop off this piece. Nothing good, let's get out of here. Let's go ahead and go, go, go. Just keep on moving on. But anyway, almost a level 51. Nice, making some progress here. Gotta get leveled. Gotta get to OP8 before the pre-sequel comes out, guys. Gotta. And then we're gonna do our own quest for completion. We're gonna complete everything in UVHM. No, we're not. I'm just gonna get to OP8. Once I'm at OP8, done. I'm done. This LP's done. I mean, it's gonna be sad to see it go. Honestly, it's gonna be sad to see it go. It's my longest running LP on my channel. It made it past 10 episodes. I think my Krieg Let's Play got to like 30 something. But this one's at 74, guys. 74. Can you believe that? 74 episodes of a Let's Play from Flairjay, the guy who never finishes any Let's Play he ever starts, ever. Besides that Krieg Let's Play. That's because you guys liked it. I couldn't. It was getting decent enough support for my channel size at the time, so I couldn't abandon it. Other LPs like the Saints Row 4-1 and stuff, I could abandon easily. Easily. Guys, don't even remember those. You don't even remember them. Anyway, I gotta teleport. Teleport to Walmart. I can never say it like Scarlett says it. Scarlett says it in such an amazingly Britishly way or whatever. That it's awesome. It's awesome. Oh, we had to raid that pier in caravan? Is this still part of the same mission? Or no? I'm going to have to end the episode off here either way. But no, I turned in the mission at the chest, didn't I? Now, is this the same? Because it's two easy pieces, right? I guess we'll go ahead and do that. Why not? Let's go ahead and do that too. Why not? I'm okay with it. Let's go raid that Pyrian caravan. I don't know what I'm at right now. I think I'm past the 20-minute mark, but not by much. So let's go ahead. I could be completely wrong. I probably am. Let's go ahead and raid this really quick. Let's go. It's time for a raid! Raid bosses. You know, speaking of raid bosses in the pre-sequel, I was talking about that like 10 minutes ago, but still, I really hope that 2K Australia and like Gearbox finally wrap their head around giving us proper rewards for their ridiculous challenges. Why is it Vora doesn't drop every legendary gun in the game on the spot? Oh, man. Legendaries. What legendaries have you guys seen in the pre-sequel that you really want? Because I've seen a few that I really, really want. One is that nailer or whatever it's called, the blah 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 blah, that Vladov thing that replaced the Lyuda, that Vladov sniper rifle. I think that looks really cool. I want it a lot. I also want the Femme Fatale because it is basically the bitch, and I love the bitch, but it looks like it's, I've only ever seen gameplay of it in Ice Element. Hopefully it's not just Ice Element. But yeah, I want that. I think there was one more that I really wanted. Can't remember though. Oh, it was, What was it? Ah, man, what was it? I can't remember. Obviously, you know, there's the Haymaker shield, but that's not legendary at all. But I obviously want that. But what loot have you guys seen that you wanna, that you want in the pre-sequel that you are just like going straight after the moment you can? I didn't open up this chest. I also haven't meleeed anything yet. At least I don't think so. So Deedle can't get mad at me this time. Deedle! Deedle! I mention you every episode. It's not fair. I have to stop. I have to stop. It's time. It's time. It's time. Boat 12! There we go. That works. Let's go turn this in now. Pretty sure that was... Yeah, that had to be one entire mission because it obviously says two easy pieces. That means that you need two pieces to complete the mission. They're not separate missions. Flare J, come on. Pay more attention. Guys, I've done well for not paying attention this episode. Leave me be. I only died once. Once! That's because I got cocky. Never again. It's gonna happen again. It's totally gonna happen again. Jay, out! I had to do that. I had to pull that Gage Echolog reference. I had to, guys. I had to. I'm talking too fast. I'm getting too hyper. Guys. 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 I can't. Flirt, Jay, are you high? I'd never get high. Drug-free for life. Is this gonna level me up? Nope. Gonna come not as close as I thought. Still got like a bar left. But anyway, guys. Anyway, next episode we're gonna go after the hermit. The hermit. It's gonna be fun, even though nobody likes the hermit. But still, I want to thank you all for watching. I very much appreciate it, and I'm gonna see you guys later. Bye.